every graffiti is advocacy for something. There are cases actually in Bosnia of street art advocacy, but not so much in some specific topics.
We have two main positions: that art is only here for art by himself, that kind of la puritanistic type of approach, but other approaches that the only true meaning of the art is when the art is here for us to make some kind of social changing, to make some kind of socio-economical and political change in our way, when the art is subversive by his efficientive nature.
Art, actually, it has been a part of people and the youth like for so many years, and it's kind of changing now. It's being shown like in different ways, like, and now it's mostly a focus on street art, so everybody can do it, and this is actually the best part of it.
Basically, in Bosnia, graffiti are mostly based on football fans and football clubs, and fascism and chauvinism between three ethnicities that we have.
Graffiti in Niš are very popular among organizations, but in a bad way. There is some kind of graffiti war between a nationalist and a fascist organization, with messages that are written on the walls in Niš.
To find the most visually appealing way to actually deliver your message, and that's art and design and advocacy would be something extremely helpful in that regards, because you kind of learn what are the efficient ways to deliver a message that would stick and remain into someone's head.
The most important thing about everything that in art design happened is that they all started to work, you know. Some of them never do any stencil, never do any sticker, never do any comics.
We can't be all of us in the television, or all of us being leaders or something. So we can only show our problems through street art, through our creations that we can have, or we can do anywhere we want.
This is something that you see on a daily basis on the street, and the message that's being delivered is a positive one. So people really get affected by it. It could be used more because it works.
You can do advocacy in politics, in laws, in any other issue through street art, which can be pretty cheap, first of all. Which can be done through guerrilla marketing.
What I saw is excellent, you know. What we have now as a final project is so amazing, because I didn't expect that much from them, because I was on some workshops. We were 12 people and only two were working, and that's why I like their enthusiasm.
I haven't known the main thing what the comics mean, like, and I searched on the internet and I saw the comics like these that we are learning here, but I didn't have a clue how to do them like in a professional way, and here we have actually, I have learned it pretty well, so I think I will definitely show this to the organization
through just one page of a comic. That's what I've learned today. We can show some message that we won't even get through 10 photographs or an article counting hundreds, thousand and something words.
If you want to engage our kids, our young people to be politically involved, to be socially responsible, to be subversive, to ask social questions, maybe we have to need and we have to put and to teach and to ask for them to be active on the whole way of media, through the every aspect, to the whole, to the comics, to the art, to the design, to everything, to the to every possible way to speak and to say what is your value, what is your responsibility, what is your answer to the circumstances that dominate through your life.